this hell shit, nigga. We numb niggas, you don't feel shit, nigga. You ain't on no real shit, nigga.
91, Cypress Hill burst upon the scene. Three crazy gun toting niggas smoking weed. Talking about life on records was the whole plan. So we put out the funky feel, but you were feeling killer, man. That was about the time we was opening up for Naughty. Didn't know shit, we were just trying to rock the party. 92, a year later, about a million records sold. From doing shows like Lollapalooza on the road. Building up momentum while spitting deadly venom. Taking pictures for High Times, me, Mugs, and Zen. Chilling with the Beastie Boys, smoking lots of weed. But it was time to hit the studio for another LP. 93 Black Sunday hits with critical acclaim. Had a monster hit from Insane in the Brain. Top the charts, held the spot for 6 weeks to boot. It was a trip to know that we were the first ones to do it in rap music, but it was a feat nonetheless. So we started getting paid and I stopped smoking stress.
You don't know no real shit, nigga. This the original Cypress Hill shit, nigga. We know niggas, you don't feel shit, nigga. You ain't on no real shit, nigga. You don't know no real shit, nigga. This the original Cypress Hill shit, nigga.
House of Pain and many more. Was even invited to Woodstock. Some niggas from the block called the Barrett Bobo and Half a Million Rock. How could all this happen at 24 years of age? Half a million bouncing to your shit from off the stage. 95, I was alive and survived so far. Still trying to cope with being a rap star. Cause that's the type of shit that can really affect your mental. This was evident in the way I wrote the tempo, with confusion and pain and hence illusion. But I still threw my setup with the critics being abusive. Even the record company, they became elusive when it comes to showing support for the Cypress Institution. 96, with no support, we were still making moves. Cypress Hill, in the summer, we were on the smoking goose. But like every legendary click, someone had to split. So the dog left the house, shit was getting kinda thick. I was with the Electric Lady, we were talking about babies. But the groupies on the road don't help you from misbehaving.
You don't know no real shit, nigga. This the original Cypress Hill shit, nigga. We numb niggas, you don't feel shit, nigga.
Yeah, we killed a few. Between us and Cube, over shit nobody knew.
I know.
The dog came back home, but after smoking grooves too. Chilling with George Clinton and Erykah Badu. This was a crazy time, we were flowing off the boom. Niggas on stage, tripping on the shrooms. 98 was kinda great, cause it felt just like before. We hit the studio, recorded Cypress Hill 4. But someone dropped the ball, as I still recall. Cause it felt Cypress Hill got no support at all. We did the last smoking grooves, but then it all was said. And the old chemistry just reared its head again. 99, I got to recline because there was no doubt that the first year was a success of the smoke out. 99 was even better than the year of 98. And Skull and Bones was coming out,